What's up, people? How's it going? Welcome to my channel and welcome to another video. So those of you who tuned into the previous vlog might have noticed that, you know, there has been some time gap between the current video and the previous one. And the reasons for that is I wanted to do some changes. So by chance I happened to, you know, find a hack for my group GoPro Hero. And that hack essentially, you know, upgraded the camera from Hero to Hero 5. Because of that, you know, I have some controls on the quality of the video and some options for higher resolution. So this one I'm, you know, using the camera in the 4K 30fps mode. So let's see how the quality is. I hope you guys can make out the difference. So this won't be the only change, you know, apart from some of the things I discussed in the previous video. So those of you who haven't checked it out, I'll link it up there. But this isn't the only change, as I said just now. I'll be getting a couple of mounts or a few mounts and try, you know, different POVs so that, you know, things get a little bit more interesting. So that's the plan. Let's see how I fare in that. So I don't know how many of you are aware, but in the 90s, a couple of scientists, you know, proposed that consciousness can be explained, or an attempt can be made by, you know, by looking at it through the lens of quantum mechanics. And one of the guys who proposed this won, you know, the Nobel Prize in 2020 for discovery or predicting black holes. I think he won it for predicting black holes. So it wasn't, you know, just some layman who proposed this, but due to various reasons, many of which are, you know, genuine and make sense, this particular proposition was dismissed. And one of the prominent reasons is quantum mechanics for particles, you know, minute tiny particles, is applicable at very low temperatures. Quantum computers, you know, the ones that are available right now, operate at, you know, minus 270 degrees centigrade, and we all know the nominal body temperature. So at these temperatures, quantum mechanics actually breaks down. It doesn't really work. However, there are still a couple of people, you know, who thought, or who are, you know, trying to investigate and find out, like, you know, how does consciousness work? Because it's one of those great mysteries of mankind. So one of the ways in which, you know, the plausibility is being explored is through fractals. So fractals is, you know, one of those self-repeating patterns, and peculiarity of it is that, you know, it has finite area but infinite boundary or perimeter. So one example would be, you know, branches of a fern. So, you know, simple patterns which repeat themselves. And the other peculiarity associated with them is that they are neither two-dimensional or three-dimensional, so they are in between. And quantum states of matter is generally, you know, in between states. So that's what it is very good at explaining. So, and probably, you know, the motivation behind this is, you know, the way in which, you know, our blood capillaries or blood vessels are organized, or, you know, the air pathways in our lungs. So, you know, some of these are, like, you know, are I mean, the patterns are, you know, fractal-esque, if I can say. So the neurons, you know, which actually facilitate our brains to function in the way they do. So the leading theory, not the leading theory, but one of the ways, you know, in which it's being explored or understood from the consciousness point of view is maybe the information that flows through these neurons or the matter or the substance that flows through the neurons is probably, you know, following fractalist patterns. So that's something that's being worked upon, and, you know, it will take some time for it to, you know, gain momentum or, you know, find acceptance or otherwise. But if it indeed pans out that way, it will be a significant, you know, achievement. What do you guys think? I mean, is it really possible that, you know, our consciousness works in quantum states? I find it an interesting theory. Do let me know what your thoughts are on that. And on that note, I'll be signing off from today's vlog, and I hope to catch you guys in the next one. So until then, peace out.